Good morning.
大家早上好。
It's a privilege to be able to share with you.
很荣幸能够在这里与大家分享。
And recently there are a lot of haze going on.
近来的烟霾的情况非常的严重。
And really affecting a lot of our breathing.
它影响了我们很多人的呼吸系统。
And the whole world is talking about climate change.
整个世界都在谈论着这个气候的转变。
And it's not something unpredicted.
Unpredicted.
Yeah.
这也不是说我们没有预期的。
Because in the Bible, it already talks about in the end times, there will be a lot of climate changes.
因为圣经里面有告诉我们说到这个末了的时候会有这个气候的转变。
And in the past 2 weeks, when we are gathering in cell, in small groups to pray,
当在过去两个礼拜，当很多的小组聚在一起祷告的时候
，and they are personally in two of the prayer meetings, God reminded us about Matthew chapter 24.
在这些祷告当中的两次祷告，神就再一次的提醒我们关于这马太福音第二十四章。
And just now I heard from another sister that in their own prayer group, they also reminded about end times.
刚才我听到一位姐妹说，在他们个别的这个祷告小组里面，他们也被提醒关于这末后的日子。
So today I want to share with you the title to live wisely.
因此，今天要给大家的这个主题是我们要活得有智慧。
And it's taken from Matthew chapter 24 to 25.
它的这个经节来自于马太福音二十四以及二十五章。
And we're going to do a bit of reading this morning.
今天早上我会读一些的经文。
In Matthew chapter 24, the first 80% talks about the second coming, the end times.
在二十四章里面，他有讲到这在末世的时候，耶稣的再次降临。
And the other 20% talks about a parable.
然后还接下来的28%就讲到了一些的比喻。
This parable of the servant.
讲到的是这个仆人的比喻。
And then Jesus continued to talk about three other parables, the parables of the 10 virgins.
接下来耶稣又继续讲论到这个十个童女的比喻。
And then talks about the parable of the talents.
然后讲到这个他连的比喻。
And then also talks about the parable of the sheep and the goat.
最后就讲到这个绵羊与山羊的比喻。
Why will Jesus talk everything at the same time?Put the four stories together with the end times.
为什么耶稣基督把这个末世和这四个比喻一起的讲完呢？
Because these four parables is to teach us how to live.
因为这四个比喻是教导我们应该如何的活。
So this morning we're going to learn how to live in the end times.
因此今天早上我们来学习在这末后的日子我们该如何的过生活。
And we're going to read 44 verses from the first part.
因此我们要从
第一个末世
第一个末世那里读起。
All right, because there are 44 verses,
因为总共有44段经文。
And because time is so limited,
而我们的时间也不够。
We're going to ask you to read in English for the first 22 verses and in Chinese from 23 to 44.
因此我要求各位先以英语来读22节，接下来再用华语读剩下的22节。
Okay?All right, let's read. Oh, it's very small, huh? Okay. Okay, if you can. All right, firstly, let's go. Then Jesus went out and departed from the temple. His disciples came out and showed him the building of the temple. And Jesus said to them, Do you see all these things? Assuredly, I say to you, not one stone shall be left here or upon another that shall not be thrown down. Now, as he sat on the Mount of Olives, the disciples came to him privately saying,Tell us, when will these things be? And what will be the sign of your coming and the end of the age? And Jesus answered and said to him, Take heed that no one deceives you, for many will come in my name, saying, I am the Christ, and will deceive many. And you will hear of wars and rumors of wars. See that you are not troubled. All these things will come to pass, but the end is not come yet. For nation will rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom. And there will be famines, pestilences, and earthquakes in various places. All these are the beginnings of sorrows. Then they will deliver you to tribulation and kill you. you, and you'll be hated by nations for my name's sake. And then many will be offended, will betray one another, and will hate one another. Then many false prophets will rise up and deceive many, and become lawlessness will abound, the love of many will grow cold. But he who endures to the end shall be saved. And this gospel of the kingdom will be preached in all the world as witness to all the nations, and then the end will come. Therefore, when you see the abomination of desolation spoken by Daniel the prophet saying in the holy place, then let those who are in Judea flee to the mountains. Let him who is on the housetop not go down to take anything out of his house, and let him who is in the field not go back to get his clothes. But woe is those who are pregnant and those who are nursing baby in those days. And pray that your flight may not be in winter or on the Sabbath, for there will be great tribulation, such that has not been seen in the beginning of the world until these times, no, nor ever shall be. And unless those days were shortened, no flesh will be saved, but for the sake of the elect's sake, those days will be shortened. 我们从二十三节开始读，华文的比较大啊。
那时候如果有人对你们说
看啊基督在这里或他在那里，你们不要相信，因为假基督和假先知们都出现，行大神迹和奇事，如果有可能甚至迷惑那些被蒙拣选的人，
看啊，我已经预先告诉你们了。
所以如果有人对你们说，看啊基督在旷野里，你们不要出去。有人说，看啊他在内室里，你们也不要相信，因为就像闪电从东边发出直照到西边，人子来临也将是这样。尸体在哪里，秃鹰就聚集在哪里。在那些日子的患难已过去，太阳就要变黑，月亮也不发亮，星辰也从天上降下，诸天和各势力也将被震动。那时候人子的征兆将要显现在天上，地上的万族都要捶胸哀哭，他们将要看见人子带着极大的权能和荣耀在天上的云彩中来临，在响亮的号角声中，他要拍拍他的天使们从四方，在天上这边到天那边，召集他所有拣选的人。他们要从你们要从无花果树那里学个比喻，当无花果树的枝子发嫩长出叶子的时候，你们就知道夏天快来了。照样，
当你们看见这一切的时候，
你们就知道人子快到了，就在门口了。我确实的告诉你们，这一切发生的事情，这世代绝不会过去，天和地将要消失，但我的话绝不会消失。至于那日子和那一时刻，没有人懂，连诸天的天使都不知道，子也不知道，唯有父知道。挪亚那些日子是怎样，人子的灵也将会怎样。在洪水以前的那些日子，人们继续吃喝嫁娶，直到挪亚进方舟的那一天，他们毫无察觉，直到洪水来到
把一切冲走。人子的来临也将是这样，
那时两个人在田里，一个被接去，一个被留下。两个女人在磨石磨推磨，一个被接去，一个被留下。所以你们要警醒，
因为你们不知道你们主哪一天来。
不过你们应当知道这一点，一家的主人如果知道贼什么时刻来，他就会警醒，不让他的房子被人钻进。你们为了这缘故也应当做好准备，因为你们的意想不到的时候，人子就来了。 Praise the Lord. Thank you.
谢谢你们，赞美主。
You know, Jesus spoke for a long time.
你知道吗？耶稣他做了很长的讲道。
The disciples just asked him one simple question.
门徒们只问了一个很简单的问题。
Wow, he poured out so many things.
但是耶稣却讲了很多很多。
He said there will be earthquakes.
耶稣说有地震。
There will be famines.
有饥荒。
And then a particular race will hate another race in verse 7.
一个族群会憎恨另外一个族群。
When I read this, I say, "Hey, it sounds very familiar."
当我读到这些的时候，哎，听起来非常的耳熟。
I think in Malaysia also have.
我相信在马来西亚也有这样的问题。
One race asks another race, balik kampung.
啊，有一个族群叫另外一个族群叫他们回家去。
It's not surprising.
这不会叫人惊讶的。
Because 2,000 years ago, Jesus already prophesied.
因为在2000年前，耶稣基督已经预言了这些事。
Of course, we love every race.
当然，我们是爱每个族群。
But this is not surprising.
但这样的事情不叫我们惊讶。
A nation will rise against another nation.
一个国家要兴起来对付另外一个国家。
Now China and Hong Kong, the same nation, they are fighting as well.
现在我们看到中国跟香港，他们是属于一个同一个国家，但是他们也在争斗着。
America and China is having trade war. They hate each other.
美国和中国之间发生的贸易战，他们彼此的憎恨。
This is not surprising.
这样的事情不叫我们惊讶。
And there will be more and more.
接下来会发生更多。
And then Jesus began to explain that we will be hated. People will hate us. People will betray us.
接下来耶稣解释说，人们会来憎恨我们。
And Jesus said, when people say that I'm outside there, don't believe them.
啊，当也而且耶稣说，当有人说耶稣就在那里，叫我们不要信。
Because the first time when Jesus came,
因为当耶稣第一次来的时候
，He took a long time.
他花了很长的时间。
He went into the mother's womb.
他进到了一个女人的这个子宫里面去。
Conceived by the Holy Spirit.
那时候是啊圣灵感孕的。
9 months, 10 months.
花了九个多月的时间。
Then Jesus came.
接下来耶稣诞生了。
But Jesus said, "That is the first time."
耶稣说，但那是第一次。
The second time.
第二次的时候。
Verse 27 says, "I'll come like lightning."
27节他说，我就像闪电一样降临。
So be aware, the second time when Jesus come again.
因此你要小心，因为当耶稣第二次降临
，Boom, Jesus came.
砰一声，他就出现了。
Like lightning.
就像闪电。
He said, "East to west, the lightning strike. Boom, Jesus came."
就如闪电从东闪到西一样，像一瞬间耶稣就出现。
And the second time when Jesus come, it will be glorious.
第二次他降临的时候，将是荣耀的降临。
There will be horns in the heaven.
因为天上要响起号角声。
31 say there will be angels everywhere.
还有他有很多的天使布满天上。
There will be beautiful clouds.
会有彩云的出现。
And Jesus will come in a magnificent glory.
耶稣会用极大的荣耀出现。
And Jesus said, "The second time when I come, it will be very glorious."
耶稣说，当他第二次降临的时候，将是一个非常荣耀的彰显。
And verse 32, it talks about the fig tree, the parable of the fig tree.
然后在32节就讲到了这个无花果的预言。
You see, when you see the fig tree start to have small leaves, I'm coming soon.
耶稣说，当你看到这个无花果的枝子发出嫩叶的时候，我就将要到了。
And all the Bible scholars understood that the fig tree referred to Israel coming back in 1948.
所有的这个解经家他们都意识到，这个无花果树发嫩芽，就是讲到在1948年以色列国再一次诞生的。
It was impossible for Israel to come back.
因为其实这个以色列国再一次诞生是不可能的事情。
But 1948, the leaf start to sprout.
在1948年，这无花果枝子的嫩叶发出来了。
And they say, "That's why I'm coming."
耶稣说，你看到这个，我要来了。
At the door, I do not. Nobody knows when's the day, but my Father will know.
他说，我不晓得我几时会来，只有天父知道。
But at that time, everybody, when Jesus come again, you and I, we will not be aware, because we will be like verse 39, we will be not aware.
但是当耶稣来的时候，我们都不会知道的。
We will still eat, we will still drink.
因为我们都会吃喝取价。
Yes, we will still get married.
我们都会吃喝取价。
And we will still eat our mooncake. 我们还是会吃我们的月饼。We will still go and play with lantern.
我们还是会去提灯笼。
Our life will go on.
我们的生活会过得像以往一样。
You and I, we will not be aware.
你跟我都不会觉察到。
One day when you are eating your mooncake, 双黄。
一天当你在吃你的这个月饼的时候。
Boom! Jesus is here.
砰的一声，耶稣就出现了。
Can it be? Yes, maybe.
可能吗？很可能是这样子。
Anytime. And in verse 40, it says,Christians will be lifted up.
那里他说在那个时候， 基督徒就会被接到天上。
The non-Christians will stay on earth.
而非基督徒会被撇在地上。
I think that's why Tesla come out with a driverless car.
Tesla.
啊，
我是想，这就是为什么 Tesla 它出了一种车叫做无人驾驶车。
Yeah, your hands and leg, you can sleep, you can still drive. 啊，
一个车不用你控制，自己走的啦。
You're aware, right? It's already in U.S. and it's on the street. It's beautiful.
啊，你都知道这辆 Tesla 的车在美国已经出现了。
Beautiful. So Christian must buy that car so that when we are lifted up, the car still can move properly.
非常漂亮的车，所以基督徒应该驾这种车，因为当我们被提的时候，车还会自己安全的驾驶。
That's just a joke. Okay, just a joke.
开玩笑，开玩笑啊。
So Jesus talks about everything.
因此，耶稣他说了很多的事。
And then Jesus said, "We are living in the end times."
然后耶稣说，我们就活在这末世的年代。
When I was growing up, everybody tell us that since the book of Acts.People are already living in the end times.
但是人家说，其实从这个《使徒行传》那个时代开始，人们已经活在末后的时代了。
But when we read the Bible and we say, "Are you sure? I don't see Jesus coming."
当我们读圣经说，哎，你说肯定吗？我都没有看到耶稣来嘞。
Earthquake, where got earthquake?
你说地震哪里有地震
？Famine, I can still eat food every day.
你说饥荒，我天天吃得饱饱的。
I don't see any of the signs.
我都没有看到任何的迹象。
That's because Malaysia is very blessed.
那是因为你活在马来西亚，马来西亚是超蒙福的。
Because Monday we will celebrate Malaysia Day, right?
我们在星期一要庆祝马来西亚日了。
Let me show you this picture.
让我给你看这张相片。
The picture on the right shows a lot of white dots.
在 on the right.
右边。
右边就出现了很多的白点，你看到一些白点。
Every white dot represents an earthquake that has happened in the last 115 years.
每一个白点是代表了在过去150年间所发生过。115年当中所发生的地震的地区。
The bigger the dot means the earthquake has higher Richter scale. The impact is bigger.
那个白点越大，就表示说那个振幅越强。
And small dot means it's a tiny earthquake.
如果是小点的话，就是说比较弱的一些地震。
You can see from the picture that there is earthquake everywhere. Malaysia has no earthquake except for maybe Sabah a little bit.
你看到到处都有地震，但是马来西亚没有地震，除了在沙巴有几个白点之外。
So Malaysia is so blessed.
因此，马来西亚是超蒙福的。
And the picture on the left.
在左边的这幅画。
You start to see a lot of blue lines.
你看到很多这些蓝色的线条。
Every line represents a path of the typhoon in the past 115 years.
每一条线就代表在过去115年间的某一个台风所经过的路径。
And if you combine these two pictures together,
如果你把这两幅画放在一起,
you have only one place that escaped everything.
你看到只有一个地方逃过这一切的结束。
Only one country that escaped every single thing.
只有一个国家逃过这一切的结束。
That is Malaysia.
那就是马来西亚。
God is good.
神非常好。
Amen.
Amen.
But,
但是
because we are living here,
就因为我们住在这里
we hardly feel it.
我们没有感觉到东西。
The Bible says there will be more and more earthquake.
圣经说会有越来越多的地震。
No feeling.
没有感觉。
Because we don't feel it.
因为我们没有接触。
Jesus says, "I'm near. I'm near."
耶稣说我很靠近了。
I don't sense it.
我感觉不到。
So today, I just want to tell you, Christ is coming back soon.
今天我要告诉你，耶稣就快再来了。
Can you tell the one next to you?
告诉你旁边的一个。
耶稣就快来了。
Jesus is coming back soon.
Okay, I can hear that you are not very convinced.
我听起来你们都不是很幸福。
Okay, let's say you are not very convinced.
就假设说你心里不是很幸福。
But at least you should believe.
至少你要相信嘛。
That you can meet Jesus anytime soon.
就是你任何时刻都可能会面对耶稣的。
Maybe later.
可能等一下。
When you are driving.
当你在驾驶的时候。
All you need is someone opposite you.
你所需要就是你所需要的只是。在你前面的一辆车从不同方向驾来的车
You just need them to be playing handphone
你只需要那个驾驶者在一面驾车一面玩手机就够了
Pum
Pum
Hey Jesus I'm meeting you already
耶稣怎么就这样就看到你了呢
All you need is one little tiny blood vessel in your brain
你所需要的就是你脑袋里面一条细细的这个血管
Pum
一下。
Jesus, I'm here.
耶稣，我来了喽。
Everything, every breath, every blood vessel is controlled in the hands of God.
你的每一个气息，你的每一条血管的血流都控制在耶稣的手里。
And if Jesus wants us to be back like the seven-year-old boy today, if Jesus wants girl, sorry, if Jesus wants her to be back, Jesus will have her back.
如果耶稣要我们现在回去，就如今天我们要送的这位七岁的小女孩一样，如果耶稣说你现在来，你现在就走了喽。
So how should we live?
因此我们该如何活呢？
We are in the end times.
我们就活在这末世。
How should we live?
我们该如何过生活呢？
We must live wisely.
我们要很有智慧的活。
So I just want to share with you four stories in a short 55 minutes time.
因此我要跟大家来分享，在短短的45分钟里跟你分享四个短短的故事。
The first two stories, Jesus is telling us that I will come back like a master.
在头两个故事里面，耶稣说，我要以主人的身份回来。
That is the parable of the servant and parable of the talent.
这就是主人的比喻，还有这个他连的比喻。
The second thing Jesus telling us that I will also come back as a bridegroom.
然后接下来的比喻也是说，我要以这个新郎的身份回来。
The expectation of a bridegroom.
我要带着这个新郎的期待出现。
And lastly, Jesus said, I will also come back with the expectation of a king to see my people.
最后耶稣说他也会以这个君王的期待回来见他的百姓。
So there is a reason why Jesus talked about all these signs and straight away tell you four stories. There must be a reason.
耶稣他有一个原因，为什么他先告诉你这幕后的这些征兆，然后告诉你这四大比喻。
Because these four parables is to teach us how to live our lives in these end times.
因为这四大比喻是教导我们如何在这幕后的日子来过生活。
First thing, Jesus will come back as our master.
首先，耶稣会以主人的身份回来。
What does a master expect?
一个主人他的期待是什么呢？
The first parable, the parable of the servant.
第一个比喻就是这个仆人的比喻。
So, to cut the long story short, the master is going away.
长话短说，我们就说这个主人他出远门了。
The faithful and wise servant,
这个忠心跟有智慧的这个仆人,
he's been given the opportunity to govern the whole house.
他被托付来掌管整个家。
So when the master is away, he did everything on time.
因此当主人不在的时候，他都会准时的把一切事情做好。
But When the master came back, the master saw it and the master said, "You are so good and you are so faithful. I want to bless you." In verse 46.
然后当主人从外地回来的时候，他看到主人的忠心，他说：“你真是很好，我要来赐福于你。”
But there's another wicked servant.
但是也有另外一个恶仆人。
When the master is not around, he's given to the opportunity to govern the whole house.
当这个主人不在的时候，他也被托付于来照顾整个家。
But he beat up other servants.
但是他却去打其他的仆人。
He went drinking, eating, and become very happy.
他去喝酒去吃了，他自己去找快乐。
And then suddenly, when the master came back,
突然间主人回来了。
Master punished him.
主人就惩罚了这个仆人。
And verse 51 says, the master called him a hypocrite.
在五十一节，这个主人就称这个仆人是一个虚伪假冒为善的人。
Yes. So what can we learn from this?
我们从这里可以学到什么呢？
What is the attitude of the evil servant?
这个恶仆人他的态度是如何？
When I read this, I realize that I always think I am like the faithful servant.
我以前常常以为说自己是那个忠心的仆人。
But when I read this, I realize that I think I am actually like the evil servant.
但是当我读这段经文的时候，我却感觉到我很像是这个恶仆人。
The evil servant, the Bible says, the evil servant say in his heart that my master is delaying. He's not coming back so soon.
因为这恶仆人心里面说，哎，我的主人他时间迟延了，他没有降早回来的。
I don't think Jesus is coming so soon.
我不觉得耶稣会很快就会回来。
I still have two young kids.
我还有两个幼小的孩子。
I want to see my daughter grow up, get married.
我要看到我女儿长大出嫁。
Oh, I want to carry my grandchildren.
我要抱孙。
I want to live under 100 years old.
我要活到100岁。
And very healthy.
我要健康的活着。
And then one day 100 years old, okay, Jesus, I want to meet you.
然后当我活到100岁的时候，说好了，耶稣现在可以去了啦。
I don't want to see Jesus so soon.
我不要这样快见到耶稣的面。
You tell me Jesus is coming back soon?
你告诉我耶稣很快就回来了。
I don't believe.
我不相信。
I think the master will delay.
我觉得我的主人会延迟时间。
I'm not ready.
我还没有准备好。
When we think like that,
当我们这样想，
we are like the evil servant.
我们就像这个恶仆人一般。
It all starts with this thought that you won't see Jesus so soon. It's impossible.
我们一开始都会有这个念头，就是说我们不会这样快见耶稣的。
And because of this attitude.
也因为这样的一个心态，
he start to beat his fellow servant.
他这个人就开始去打他的其他的仆人。
What does it mean by beating your fellow servant?
打你的其他的仆人是什么意思呢？
In the past, master will beat the servant. When they did things wrong, the master will beat them. In Jesus' times,
在耶稣的时代，如果是这个主人的话，他们会打仆人的。
When they did something wrong,
当这仆人做错的时候，
of course now we cannot do such a thing. If you beat your mate, you trust me, you'll go to jail.
当然现在我们不可以这样做，如果你回家打你的女佣的话，你看看坐牢了咯。
But when you beat the master, it shows that this evil servant is trying to be the master himself.
但是我们看到这个恶仆人他去打其他的仆人，意思什么呢？意思说这个仆人自己想做主人。
When the master is not wrong, I am the master.
现在主人不在，我就是主人了。
I can do what I want.
我要做什么我就可以做什么。
I decide what I want to do.
我自己决定我要做什么。
Is your life like that?
你的生活是否是这样呢？
Let's think of our lives.
我们想想一下我们自己的生活。
Jesus is not back soon.
耶稣还没有这样早来哦。
I can decide. I want to migrate, I migrate.
哎，我可以决定，我现在决定要移居，我就移居。
I want to divorce, I divorce.
我要决定要离婚，我就离婚。
I want to buy a house, I buy a house.
我想要买间屋子，我就买间屋子。
Seek God.
寻求神。
That is for other people, not for me.
哎，这种事情让别人去做就好了。
This is the sign of an evil servant.
这些都是恶仆人的一些征兆。
The evil servant also went to eat and drink and get drunk and enjoy and satisfy his own desire.
恶仆人他也会去吃吃喝喝，去寻求欢乐，让自己快乐。
Important is I must feel good, satisfy my own desire first.
重要的是我自己感觉到爽。
And you know, in 2 Timothy, it already tells us that in the end times, there will be people who really love themselves, really love money, very boastful and proud. All the yellow words, without self-control, lovers of pleasure rather than lovers of God. And you must have nothing to do with such person.
在提摩太后书三章一节到五节。
I have something wrong with the clicker. Can you help me click next? Sorry. Okay.
Okay. Yeah. 那也就告诉我们，当时候那些人会怎么样？会爱自己、爱钱财、自夸、骄傲，不能够自制啊，自以为是，爱享乐过于爱神。
Yeah, have nothing to do with such a person.
来说这样的人，你不要跟他有来往。
In the end times, Bible tells you, in the end times, a lot of people will be like that. They love themselves.
圣经告诉我们，在这个末后的日子，人会是这样子的，他们爱自己。
There's never a such generation in this world that love themselves so much than our current generation.
其实，在人类的漫长的历史里面，没有一个时代是像我们这个时代。这个时代人是超爱自己的。
We all love ourselves.
我们非常爱自己。
That's why we create a page for ourselves.
这也就是为什么我们为自己开了一个
社交网站，
一个社交网站的一个版面。
Facebook, Instagram, Weibo, whatever you say. Nowadays, we all love ourselves.
不管是 Facebook, Instagram, 都有我们自己的一个版面。
We put our picture there and tell everybody, come and look at me.
我们把自己的相片贴上去，叫所有人来看我们。
Or when if I have the thought about government.
当我对这个政府有一些的想法的时候，
I will tell the whole world.
我就告诉全世界。
Look at my thoughts.
来读一下我的这个思想。
I love myself. We think our thoughts are the most important thing in the world. Come and see.
我爱我自己，我觉得我自己的思想是全世界最重要的思想。
There's nothing wrong with social media. I still use it every single day.
社交网站本身没有错，我本身也有用。
A few years back, one day I realized that. after I post picture, I still
post. 几年前，当我把这个相片贴上去的时候
，Every few hours, I realize I will go back and check.
每隔几个小时，我都会回去查询。
Guess what I'm checking?
你猜我查询什么
？I check for this sign.
我查询有多少个赞？
哇 ，my picture 300 over people like 嘞！
哇，有300多人赞我嘞！
哇哇 ，I put this statement, 200 people give me thumbs up. 哇！
哇，我就写了，哇，有200个人给我赞了，
爽啊！
爽嘞！
哇 ，I love myself.
我很爱自己。
The Holy Spirit spoke to me.
圣灵跟我说话。
He said, "How come you are going back to the same thing and check and check and check, and you are always looking at the number of likes?"
为什么你一直回去查看同一个东西，而是每次查看只是看那个号码呢
？What are you thinking in your heart?
你的心里面到底在想什么呢？
So I was thinking, why am I thinking? Why am I checking? When I go in, I just look at the number. I want the number to be as big as possible. The thumb sign, good, 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 good.
我就问我到底我要什么？我在查什么？因为我每次去看，我就希望看到号码越大越好。
I realize, I love myself.
我就发觉到原来我爱自己。
Chinese say 自夸。I want to boast to people. This is me. Look at my lifestyle. Like me. Give me a like.
我很自夸，我希望大家都来说，哇，你的这个生活方式好啊。
I repented.
我就悔改了。
I said, God help me.
我说主啊，你来帮助我。
I still post every day. I still post.
我其实我现在还是会有一些贴文的。
But I'm careful when I post. What is my heart? Where's my attitude?
但是我现在很小心，我每贴的一个东西，我的心态到底是什么样
的？Social media is neutral.
社交网站本身是中性的。
It helps to connect people.
它协助人能够彼此的联系。
Through social media, I know, oh, someone has given birth. Oh, somebody father passed away. I can know a lot of things.
透过这个社交网站，我知道说，哦，这个人他的孩子出生了，那个人的亲人去世了。
Social media also do a lot of nice marketing. You can business people can use social media to do marketing.
而且这个生意人，我们都可以用这些的社交网站来做生意。
But social media for me, I use it like my newspaper. I don't subscribe to any newspaper. I just like all the U.S., U.K., Australia, China news. Every news that morning, all the news will tell me what is happening. So I love social media.
但是我把这个社交网站当成是我的报纸而已，因为我本身没有订阅报纸。
So I say social media is good.
所以我说社交网站其实是好的。
But
但是
，Let us be careful.
我们都要小心。
Guard your heart.
我们要守着我们的心。
The Bible in Proverbs says, "Above all else, guard your heart." When you look, post it, ask yourself, "What is your heart thinking?"
这个箴言告诉我们说，最重要的是要谨守我们的心。
Amen. And the master called this evil servant, "You are a hypocrite."
然后这个主人称这个恶仆人为假冒为善的。
Because when I'm around, you do something. When I'm not around, you show me another kind of behavior.
因为当我在的时候，你是一个样；当我不在的时候，你是另外一个样。
So your ending will be like the hypocrite, the same ending where there will be crying and gnashing of teeth.
因此，你的下场就跟那个假冒为善的人一样，在那里以后有哀哭切齿。
That means in church we are one kind. When we go back to our home, we behave another way.
也就是说，你来到教会，你是一个样；你回到家里之后，你变成另外一个样。
Or in church you praise God, at home you beat your wife. That is.
你来教会赞美神，回去打老婆。
That is a hypocrite.
那是假冒为善。
Let us not be hypocrite.
让我们都不要成为假冒为
善的人。But a faithful and wise servant.
但是一个有智慧又忠心的仆人。
The Bible says, "Give them food, give the family food in due season."
他说他会按时分粮给家人。
Even when the master is not at home,
甚至当这主人不在家
he is still doing it faithfully.
他还是忠心的做事。
That's why faithfulness is being consistent.
因此要忠心就必须要持守，要每一次做的一样。
对，要一致。When you do things, you must be consistent.
对，做事情要一致性。
So, is our life consistent?
因此，我们的生命有没有一致性呢？
Are you handing every part of your life to God?
你是否将你生命的方方面面都交给神呢？
You say, my children, I have headache. I don't know how to raise my children. This one I give to God. God, you take care of my children.
哎呀，我孩子，我真的不会管了。主啊，你管吧。
Or business.
生意。
Business is different.
生意不一样。
I cannot hand to God.
不可以交给上帝的。
I must decide. I must strategize.
我一定要做决定哦，我要来做策略。
That is not consistent.
这样的话就没有一致性了。
A wise servant is consistent in every single part of their life. Everything belongs to God. Everything I seek God, and that is called faithfulness.
一个忠心的仆人，他很有智慧的，他把每一件事情都交付于神，这才是一致性。
And he will be rewarded to rule over all the things in future.
在将来，他会得到奖赏，来掌管万事。
When Jesus comes again,
当耶稣再来的时候。
A wise and good servant will be raised up to rule over the new heaven and new earth.
那个忠心良善的仆人会被兴起来掌管整个宇宙。
You all know about the new heaven and new earth in future.
你都知道将来有个新天新地吧。
And we will reign with Christ when we are found faithful and wise.
当耶稣知道我们是忠心良善的时候，他会把我们兴起来与他一起作王。
Amen. So tell the one next to you.Our Lord is seeking for faithful servant.
告诉你隔壁人说，我们的主在寻找忠心的仆人。
好不好？跟你隔壁的说啊。
跟你旁边的说，我们的主在寻找忠心的仆人。
That is consistency.
这就是一致性。
Let our fear be fear of God be consistent inside church and outside church.
让我们对神的敬畏不只是在。教会里面，当我们离开教会的时候，也要保持这样的敬畏。
And let God be the master, not just in one part of our life, but in every part of our life.
而且让神做主，不是在我们生命的某一方面，而是我们生命的每一个方面，他都做主。
So are you ready to meet God anytime?
因此，你是否已经准备好任何时刻准备好面对神呢？
A good servant can meet God anytime.
一个好的仆人能够在任何一个时候面对神。
After the service, after lunch, no problem.
不管是聚会过后，或者是用餐之后。
Anytime I can meet our Lord, that is a good and faithful servant.
任何一个时候，你都准备好面对你的神。
The second parable is the parable of the talents.
第二个就是这个受托银子的比喻。
To cut the story short, there is a master who gave three servants 1,000, 5,000, 2,000, and 5,000.
基本上神、这个主人把、这些财物分给三个仆人，一个
1,000，
一个
2,000，
2,000，
对，
一个5,000，一个2,000，一个1,000。
Yes, 1,000, 2,000, all right. And、in English, it's actually called talent. So it's actually one talent, five, two talents, and five talents.
它的原文其实是他连，所以是。一个他连，两个他连，五个他连。
So the story goes by the 5,000 quickly earn 5,000 more. Okay, so he has 10,000. That is in verse 16. 5,000 plus 5,000, you got 10,000.
啊，那第十六节讲到这个得到五个他连的这个仆人，他就很快的再去赚回五个他五。
2,000 also earn another 2,000.
然后那个两个他连的又再赚了两个他连。
And the 1,000.Open a hole, hide it, and kept it properly.
但是那个拿到一个他连的，却挖了一个洞，把这一个他连埋起来了。
And we all know the story. The master came back, look at the 5,000 and 2,000, and say, "You good and faithful servant."
当主人回来的时候，他看到这得到五个他连跟两个他连的，他说：“你们两个都是忠心啊，良善的仆人。
You are good and faithful in many things. I will give you to rule over all the things."
他说。你们都是忠心的，我要让你们来掌管许多的事。
And tell the last one.
然后他就告诉了第三个仆人。
You are a wicked and lazy servant.
你是一个又懒又恶的仆人。
So he threw him to the dark, into the dark, when there is again crying and gnashing of teeth. It's the same ending. All the evil servant has the same ending.
所以主人就把这恶仆人丢到这黑暗里去，在那里有哀哭切齿。所以所有的恶仆人都有同样的下场。
All right.Here it doesn't mean going to hell. It doesn't mean that you are the servant is going to hell, but it's definitely not an enjoyable place.
这里不表示说这个仆人就会下地狱，但是结局是不好受的。
All right. What can we learn from this?
从这里我们学到什么呢？
It starts with the same attitude.
从开始就是态度。
The wicked and lazy servant. The Bible says here, a man.The kingdom of God is like a man traveling to a far country, far, far away.
他告诉我们说，这个天国就像一个人要出外旅行。
And in English, it's a better word because in Chinese, 旅行 sounds like a very short trip. But in English, it says a far country means imagine in the past they ride a horse or a donkey and go to a far country. It will take them months or even years.
在英文里讲的比较好，它是远行。所以在过去，如果远行的话，一出门就是好几个月。
And the wicked servant is lazy.
然后这个恶仆人是懒惰的。
Even though the master is going for months and years,
虽然这主人出门可能几个月，甚至是几年
，but he did nothing with the money.
但是他对这笔钱他没有做什么。
When I was young, when I listened to this, actually I think the 1,000 is considered quite faithful.
当我年轻的时候，当我读到这一段，我就说，哎，那个得到一他连这个仆人其实很忠心嘞。
他没有跑路哎 ，he didn't run away 嘞。He actually kept it, no? I thought actually quite faithful, right?
他好好的把钱存下来，其实这是很忠心，对不对
？Why you call him lazy?
但是为什么你讲他懒
？Then I began to realize.
后来我就发现到
，one talent of gold is equal to 6,000 denarii.
就是一个他连就相等于6000个
德
纳
利 ，OK。And one denarius is equal to one day of salary.
一个德纳利相等于一天的工资。
That means when you get 1,000, so-called
one talent,
in Chinese it's called 1,000, but it's English one talent.
因此，当你得到一个他连的时候
，you get 6,000 days of your salary.
其实那里相等于6000个天的工资。
That means the first one get 16 years of salary.
因此，第一个仆人得到的是16年的工资。
The second one received 33 years of salary.
第二个仆人得到33年的工资。
That's a lot. And the last one, they got 82 years of salary.
最后一个仆人得到82年的工资。
No wonder the master called them faithful.
难怪主人称这些仆人忠心。
If my master gives me 82 years of my salary,
如果我的主人给我82年的工资
，and my master tells me that he's going to come back far, far away, going to take a long time.
然后主人告诉我说，他要去很远的地方，要很久之后再回来。
I will surely 跑路。
I will run away with the money.
82 years, I don't need to work. I just think I run to any place to hide. I can spend all the money my whole life. I can enjoy my whole life. That is why they are called very faithful.
接下来82年我根本都不用做工了，跑掉就可以了嘛。这就是为什么神说你是忠心的仆人。
They took 82 years of salary, earn another 82 years, and give back to God 164 years and say, this is not mine, it's still yours. Wow, that's so faithful.
然后他拿了这80年的工资去赚回另外80年的工资，总共是140多年的工资，就说这是主人的，不是我的，都归还给主人了。
The 33 years is also the same. They give back.To the master said, "It's not mine; it's yours."
那是得到33年工资也是一样，他就去赚了一笔相等的，就还给他的主人。
16 years is also not a small amount.
16年工资其实也不少。
And he just hide it.
但是他却藏了。
And the master is going far, far away.
这个主人去了很远的地方。
So during this time, what did he do?
在这段时间里面，他做了什么呢
？Nothing.
什么都没做。
Nothing.
什么都没做。
He just hide it.
他就把钱藏起来。
That's why the master is so angry.
这就是为什么主人非常的生气。
That's why some mother can understand.
因此，有一些母亲就会明白。
He said, "Hey, I'm going whole day. I'm going out to work whole day. When I come back, please do this one simple piece of homework."
啊，妈妈说，哎，我现在要去做工一天啊，麻烦你哦，把这功课做好啊。
Only one page.
只是一面而已。
Or the mother go went out to work, came back.
妈妈出去做工一整天，回来之后。
Blank paper.
哇，空的嘞。
What have you been doing?
哎，你做了什么
？So angry.
很生气。
He said, "I just watch TV and play computer game."
我看电视咯，打 game 啦。
Ah,、oh, the mother so angry.
妈妈很生气。
The same feeling.
同样的感受。
I have been away so long.
我离开很久了。
Jesus said, "I've been away so long, and I give you a whole life."
耶稣说，我离开很久了，我给你一整。
人生
生命，整个人生。
I give you your whole life to do something.
我给你整个人生来做一些的事情。
You tell me you did nothing.
然后你告诉我你什么都没做。
Nothing.
什么都没做。
How can that be? Lazy.
可以这样子。
That's the same feeling.
就是这样的一个感受。
But the wicked person said, I'm afraid.
但是这个恶仆人他说我很怕。
I'm afraid you will scold me.
我怕你骂我。
His feeling is afraid.
他的感受是害怕。
And the master said, you knew. So you knew who I want, what I want. He said, you knew that I will reap where I have not sown, and I will gather where I have not seed, where I have not sowed, reap.
那主人说，你很知道我是讲那个伟人，我在不播种的地方要收获，在没有投放的地方要收取的。
You also know my expectation.
你知道我对你的期待。
Yet you did nothing.
但是你却什么都没做。
You did nothing with your time.
你对你的时间什么都没做。
You did nothing with your money.
你对你的钱什么都没做。
You did nothing with your giftings.
你对你的恩赐也什么都没做。
You did nothing with your brain.
你对你的脑袋也什么都没做。
You just live your life nothing.
你是这样子什么都没做来过你的生活。
That's why the master is not happy.
就是这样子，主人非常生气。
You see, the evil servant is afraid of God, but it's different from fearing God.
你知道吗？这个恶仆人他很怕神，但是他对神的怕不等于他对神的敬畏。
Maybe your friend, your cell group leader say, hey, "Can you share your testimony? It's a very good testimony. Just share in the cell group."
比如说，你的小组的组长说，哎，你的这个见证很好，跟你的组员分享，可以不可以
？I cannot, I scared.
不要，不要，很怕，不要。
Later I say something wrong or people laugh at me, I don't want.
你在讲错话，给人笑。
Yeah. So you are focusing on yourself.
因此你的注意力就在你自己。
You don't want people to laugh at you.
你不要人笑你。
Your focusing is on your whole focus is on your own self.
你整个的焦距就在自己。
But someone who is good and faithful focus on God.
但是一个忠心的仆人，他的焦距是神。
I know what my master want.
我知道我的神要我做什么。
So I will do my best, and I will give it a try.
我要尽我的最好的，要来尝试一下。
Maybe another sister came and asked you, "Hey, your curry is very nice. Why not you go to Eden and cook 1 week of curry?"
也许另外一个姐妹，哎，你的咖喱煮得很好吃，好不好？花一个礼拜的时间，去那个伊甸里面煮给大家吃啦。
Cannot, I'm afraid.
不要老怕嘞。
Later people laugh at my curry not nice.
等下人家笑我咖喱煮得不好吃。
Again, focus on yourself.
再一次的，你把焦距放在自己身上。
You think of what God wants.
你要想到神要你得到什么。
God wants you to multiply your talent.
神要你来繁殖你的恩赐。
The more you cook, the better you will be.
你煮得越多，你会煮得越好。
You have the courage to try new things.
你要有这个勇气去尝试新的事情。
So when the master comes back, he wants to see faithfulness.
当主人回来的时候，他要看的是忠心。
He also wants to see.Fruitfulness.
而且他要看果效。
Fruitfulness.
要有结果子。
Tell the one next to you, fruitfulness.
告诉各位要结果子。
Fruitfulness is not just in church, Saturday or Sunday.
结果子不只是在教会礼拜天啊拜六。
If you are a boss, having a business of more than 100 people under you.
啊，你的身体里面有超过100个手下。
Fruitfulness is thinking, how can I reach out to them? How can I plan for them? How can I strategize and lead them?
所谓的有果效能够结果，就是你一直想说，我要如何为他们来策划，来引导他们。
If you are a chef,
如果你是一个大厨，
how will fruitfulness be to you?
对你来说，效率是什么呢？
Ask God, what do you want me to do? How do you want me to influence my kitchen?
你要求神说，主啊，你要教导我，我怎么样来影响我的厨房。
If you're an accountant that stares at a computer from 8 to 6 o'clock, just looking at a computer every day.
如果你是个会计师，你一天八九个小时瞪着这个电脑荧光幕。
What will fruitfulness be for you?
对你来讲，结果子是什么意思呢？
To increase your knowledge.
要增加你的知识。
To love your colleagues.
爱你的同事。
To show leadership in your company.
在你公司里面彰显你的领导才华，
That is called fruitfulness.
这就是要有结果子。
And also apply in church.
同样的东西能够运用在教会。
There are many places where the church need people.
教会有很多方面需要人手的。
Need your knowledge.
教会需要你的知识。
To be a fruitful church.
要让这个教会成为一个多结果子的教会。
Amen. So in the end, The wicked servant is thrown into the eternal darkness where there is weeping and gnashing of teeth.
最后，这个恶仆人就被丢在黑暗里，在那里有哀哭和切齿。
So we all do not want to be the lazy servant.
所以我们都不要成为这个懒惰的仆人。
We all will be the good and faithful servant.
我们要成为这个又好又忠心的仆人。
But the nice thing about this story.
但是啊，这故事的好的一面是。
Whether you are the 2,000 or 5,000,
不管你得到两个他连或者五个他连的
，your praise, your reward is exactly the same.
你所得到的赞赏，你所得到的奖励是完全相等的。
Sometimes you look at people, wow, God, you give him so much talents, so much leadership. You see, you didn't give him so much. It's not fair.
有时候你告诉神啊，你给那个人这样多的才华。你什么都没有给我。
There are so much money, you didn't give me so much. How not fair?
你给他这样多钱，你没有给我钱，不公平嘞。
As long as you do the same thing to glorify God,
只要你做同样的事情，那就是荣耀神。
One day when we meet God,
有一天当我们见神的时候
，everything is exactly the same.
我们所得的奖赏跟称赞是完全一样的。
Even the comma, even the full stop, is exactly the same.
甚至是那个标点符号都是完全一致的。
Because it does not belong to us.
因为这都不属于我们。
You see the two person, they have a good mentality.
你知道吗？这两个仆人他们的态度非常好。
The time, the talent, the money you give me does not belong to me.
你所给我的时间，你所给我的才华都不属于我。
It belongs to the master.
都属于主人的。
That's why 他们不像我会跑路啊。They are not like me. They will run away. They will keep it and present it back to the master.
他们都会把主人交给他们的东西保守好，然后再归还给主人。
And it can be shown here. Towards the end, the master took the 1,000 and he didn't give it to the 4,000. He gave it to the 10,000.
啊，最后当主人把这一个他连夺回来之后，他没有给那个拥有四个他连的，把给他那个有十个他连的。
When I was thinking, I said, "Wow, very not fair." 嘞。
当我在想，哎，我想，哎，这样就做有不公平
了。He has 10, he has 4. You took the 1, you didn't give to the 4, you give to the 10. Now he has 11 and 4. How can it be fair?
这个人有十个他连，这个人有四个他连，你拿了那个人的一个他连，给了那个十个他连，哎，那个人变成有十一个他连了嘞。
11 4, it's not fair.
现在分布是11:4，哎，哪里公平？
But it also tells us a story.
但是这里告诉我们一个故事。
Who God wants to give is none of your business.
神要给谁跟你没关系。
And it also tells us another story, another meaning behind this.
又告诉我们另外一个意义。
11 and 4 does not belong to them. It still belongs to the master.
不管是11份或者是4份都不属于他们，这一切都属于上帝。
Our concept must be changed.
因此我们的观念要改变。
There's no need to compare.
不需要比来比去的。
Everything belongs to God.
所有的都是上帝的。
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So let us use all our resources, all our time, all our giftings, all every opportunities that God has given you, and use it to glorify God, love God, and love man.
因此，让我们来使用所有的资源、所有的金钱、所有的时间，神所给我们的所有的恩赐，来荣耀他。
Not to glorify yourself.
不是来荣耀我们自己。
Again, not like 2 Timothy, to boast, not to boast, but to glorify God.
也不要像这提摩太后书所讲的，要来夸耀自己。
But to glorify God.
但是要来荣耀上帝。
So our dear Lord Jesus will come back as a master.
好叫我们亲爱的耶稣回来的时候，他是以主人的身份出现。
He's also coming back as a bridegroom.
他也是要以新郎的姿态来回来。
The Bible says he is the bridegroom and the church is the bride.
圣经告诉我们说，耶稣是那新郎，教会是那个新妇。
Church is not the building, it is us.
教会不是建筑，教会是我们这班人。
So we come to this third parable, the parable of the virgin.
然后我们来讲到这第三个比喻，就是十个童女的比喻。
Basically, to cut a long story short, there are 10 virgins. Five are wise virgins and five are foolish virgins.
啊，长话短说，就是有十个童女，十个啊，五个是有智慧的童女，另外五个是愚错的童女。
The wise one has lamb and oil, the foolish one has lamp, not enough oil.
聪明的童女手上有灯也有油，但是愚错的只有灯没有油。
So they all went out.
他们都出去了。
The Bible didn't say it's night time, but I assume it's night time. If not, why you bring lamb outside, right?
圣经没有说那时候是晚上，但是我假设是晚上，要不然你为什么要提灯呢？
So at night they all bring lamb and walk.
晚上他们都拿这个灯走。
Suddenly the bridegroom came.
突然间这个新郎来了。
Say I'm here.
我来了。
Here.
来了。
Then the five wise virgins.They light up their lamp and say, we have the lamb. Okay, come, we follow you.
然后那五个聪明的这个童女，他们就马上点灯说，好了，我来跟你了。
But the five foolish ones say, we have not enough oil.
但是那五个愚蠢说，哎，我的油不够嘞。
And they went to ask the wise ones say, can borrow a bit.
他们就去找那五个聪明的，哎，可不可以借一点来用。
But in verse 9, they say, we cannot share.
但是第九节告诉我们，绝不能够咯。
You have to go and buy yourself.
你要自己去买嘞。
So the foolish one desperate, you know.
哦，那个愚蠢的，他们说当时就很急了。
So they really going to buy.
他们跑去买了。
When they came back,
他们回来的时候
，the wise one already enter in.
那个五个聪明的已经进去了。
And they shut the door.
然后就关上门。
So the foolish one knock, say, Lord, Lord, open the door.
那五个蠢的在敲门说，哎，开门，开门。
And the bridegroom speak behind the door.
然后那个新郎就在门后面说话。
I tell you, I don't know you.
让我告诉你，我不认识你。
And then verse 13, it says, make sure you are watchful. Let me see. So keep watch, because you do not know the day and the hour.
第十三节就告诉我们，所以你们要警醒，因为你们不知道那日子和那时刻。
We are the virgins.
我们就是这些童女。
Because in 2 Corinthians chapter 11 tells us very clearly,
因为在哥林多前书，后书，对不起，十一章二节很清楚地告诉我们。
Let's read in English, then in Chinese. Ready, 1, 2, 3. I am jealous for you with a godly jealousy. I promise you to one husband, to Christ, so that I might present you as pure virgin to him. 华语，我以神的热心热爱你们，因为我已经把你们许配给一位丈夫。作为贞洁的童女献给基督。 So we are the virgins.
我们都是童女。
We are supposed to be married to one husband.
我们都要嫁给一个丈夫。
Christ.
就是基督。
And then in another verse he says, he's coming back to have a wedding, and we are the bride, we must get ourselves ready.
然后他又说他要回来要举办一个婚宴，因此身为这个新娘的我们要准备好。
And you know,In English, it's very clear. The wise virgins took oil in jars.
英文的圣经讲得很清楚。他说这些聪明的这个童女，他们是用这个大缸装油的。
In Chinese, it says 瓶子里有油。It gives a picture of a beautiful dressed lady with a beautiful little lamb. A bit of oil, and then wait, you know, where's my bride?
哦，圣经里面讲的很像是那个。灯油灯很小哦，那个漂亮的女子打扮得漂亮，拿这个小小油灯这样子哈，婀娜多姿在走。
Yeah, but when I read the English, I realize the picture become like giant supermarket, you know.
但是当我读英文圣经的时候，它的图画就像你去到 giant store 有没有？
买油啊 ，Imagine I don't know how many, let's say 6 bottle of two-liter oil.
你想象一下，你去到 giant 里买。六罐的这两公斤的油
，dress in wedding gown，
你穿着这个新娘的这个嫁衣
，three bottles，
左手三罐，右手三罐，
哇 ，totally not elegant，
哇，一点都不优雅
，totally very ugly，
非常难看。
But why did they do that？
为什么要这样做
？Why they walk like going to supermarket？
就像是人家安迪去巴萨这样子。
Because they are willing to wait.
因为他们愿意等。
You know, a brother, I share this story with another brother. The brother told me that, hey, you know, last time when I 拜拜啊, I realized one bowl of oil can burn for a long time, you know.
有一个弟兄他跟我分享说他以前他拜神的时候那一碗油哦哇可以烧很久嘞。
I said, wow, now you tell me there are jars of oil.
然后他告诉我现在你告诉我你要带哇一罐一罐的油嘞。
哇 I can burn for a long long time.
哇，这个要烧久了这样子。
Oh, I realize.
我就明白了。
A wise virgin is willing to wait and is ready to wait.
一个聪明的童女，她是愿意等，而且她准备好要等。
Whether is it wasted or not, it doesn't matter.
不管这些油最后会不会浪费掉，不要紧。
Just need to prepare a lot of oil.
你只需要准备很多的油。
And when I read this story, I also cannot imagine because we in Asia, our wedding is not like that.
我也不能够想象，因为我们在亚洲，我们的穿着不是这样子。我们的这个婚礼不是这样子的。
Yeah, the bride won't be walking around and waiting which day I get married, which day I want to get married.
那个新郎不会说，哎，你们等哦，等有一天我要来娶人，我就来喽。
I went to search, I began to realize, oh, in Jesus' time, the wedding is different.
我就去搜寻了，我就发现，在耶稣的时代，他们的婚礼是不一样的。
The man and the woman will come together and have a betrothal ceremony like an engagement.
然后就是那个他们会举办一个订婚仪式。
And after the ceremony, they will be pronounced husband and wife.
在这订婚仪式过后，他们就被宣告说他们已经成为夫妻了。
And then the husband will say bye bye to the lady.
那丈夫就会跟太太讲拜拜了哦。
And the husband will go, and this time they cannot meet each other.
然后这个先生就离开，在这段时间他们不可以见面的哦。
And he will go find a land, and he will build a house for their family.
他会离开去找一块地，为他们的家来建一个屋子。
Of course, if he's not skillful, he will take maybe a year or so. But if he's skillful, maybe a few months.
如果他的技术不好，可能要花上一年的时间；如果他技术好的话，可能几个月的时间就可以了。
So after he built a house,
当他建完屋子之后
，he must ask his father to check.
他要叫他自己的父亲来检查一番。
Father, what do you think of my house?
哎，爸爸，你看怎么样？我建的可以吗
？The father comes in.
爸爸走进来看看。
哇 ，no kitchen cabinet.
哇，没有这个厨房的柜子的。
How to put your plates and pots?
你的盘子，你的锅要放哪里呢
？Okay.
Okay. 坐。
Okay, Father, please come and check.
Okay, 爸爸，你看现在可以没有？
哇 ，your toilet bowl 的 pipe so small, sure will clog up and jam on.
哇，你厕所的 pipe 这样小条，那个大便粗一点，不是不会出来咯
？Yeah, and you know in some country the toilet tissue paper cannot throw in the toilet bowl one, no?
在有些国家哦，你的这个纸巾不可以丢在这个马桶。
Cannot. You must change so that you can flush.Very convenient for your wife.
对，拜要大大条的，等一下冲洗才容易吗
？Okay, change the pipe, change the pipe.
Okay 了，换纸油了。
And finally, when the father said, "Okay, now can ready."
好，最后爸爸讲可以了啦。
The bridegroom on the unknown day will come back and say, "Here I am."
那个新郎在人家不知道的日子突然间讲，哎，我来了嘞。
Oh, no wonder the story is like that.
难怪那个故事是这样子的。
When I read this story, I begin to see, no wonder Jesus says, I'm like the bridegroom.
难怪耶稣他说他自己就像是这个新郎。
Jesus says, I'm going to heaven to prepare a
place,
room for you.
耶稣说我回去天上是为你准备住的地方。
That day, I do not know when I'll come back.
我也不知道几时会回来。
Only my father will know.
只有天父知道。
When my father says, good enough, then I'll come back.
当天父说，哎，这个地方准备到可以了，我就来了。
That is why Jesus says, I am the bridegroom, and you are my bride.
这也就是为什么耶稣说，我是那新郎，你们是新娘。
Beautiful.
It's 美丽吗
？Very beautiful. When I understand this, I say, oh, it's beautiful.
当我明白了这些，我说，哦，这是非常美丽的。
Important thing is you must have oil.
最重要的是你要有油。
What is oil?
油是什么呢
？Oil represents the spirit of God.
油代表了神的灵。
It means that you must have the relationship with God.
也就是说你要与神有这个关系。
You see, the oil cannot be shared.
油是不可以分享的。
The relationship with God cannot be shared.
你与神的关系不可以与别人分享的。
If the husband has good relationship with Christ, the husband cannot share with the wife to have a good relationship with Christ.
如果身为丈夫的与基督有很好的关系，这个丈夫不可以把他与基督的关系分给他老婆的。
If the mother has good relationship with God, the mother cannot share the oil with the children and say, "Come with me to heaven."
如果这母亲她有油的话，她不会说我把这个油分给我的子女，说跟子女说，来，你跟我一起上天堂。
Everybody must buy their own oil.
每一个人要去买自己的油。
Everybody must build their own relationship with Christ.
每一个人要与基督建立个人的关系。
You cannot share.
这是不可以分享的。
And in the end, the wicked servant says, "Lord, Lord, open the door." But the bridegroom says, "I do not know you."
最后呢，这个愚拙的这个童女说，主啊，主啊，求你开门。主人却说，我不认识你。
There is another two places in the Bible, two places where it has the same story and says, "Lord, Lord, open the door." But the person says, "I do not know you."
还有两处，你同样说，主啊，主啊，请你开门，但是主却说，我不认识你。
One is in Luke chapter 13.
一个是在路加福音十三章。
He says, "Lord, Lord, open the door," and say, "I do not know you. Where are you from?"
他说，主啊，主啊，请你开门。主说，我不认识你是哪里来的。
But, and then they respond to the person and say, "We ate and drink in your presence, and we taught in the street."
然后这些人就会反映说，哎，我曾经跟你们一起吃过、喝过，我们在大街上也教导过。
They say, "Lord, I came to Sunday service. I eat the bread. I drink the ribena. I know."
你说主啊，我在这个主日的崇拜，我这里喝了那 ribena， 我吃了那个饼干呢。
I ate and I also drank.
我有喝，我也有吃过。
But the master says.
但是主人说
"You are workers of iniquities."
他说你是恶仆人。
You have done a lot of evil.
你做了很多的恶事。
Which means these people they can come to church every single day.
也就是说，这些人他们每个星期都可以上教会。
But when they are back at home,
但是他们回家之后
，when nobody knows them,
当没有人看到他们的时候
，they deliberately, purposely choose to live in sins when nobody knows.
他们就刻意的选择活过着罪恶的生活，那是没有人看见的。
Nobody is perfect.
没有人是完美的。
We will still sin.
我们都会犯一些罪。
But we should not deliberately choose to live in sin.
但是我们不应该刻意的选择活在罪中。
Another passage is in Matthew chapter 7.
另一段经文就在马太福音第七章。
He says again, "Lord, Lord, open the door."
在这里再一次他说，主啊，主啊，你开门吧。
He said, "We have prophesied in your name. We've cast out demons in your name."
他说，我们奉你的名发预言赶鬼的。
But the person said, "I do not know you. You have done a lot of, you practice lawlessness."
但是主人却说，我不认识你们，你们这些作恶的人。
Lawlessness means you purposely live in sin while you are in church, showing a lot of different things.
做的就是说你故意的刻意的去活在罪中，你在教会可能做了很多事。
Everyone must be careful.
每个人都要小心。
Make sure you have the oil.
你要确保自己有油。
Make sure you and I we have our own relationship with Christ.
我们要确保我们自己与基督有个人化的关系。
It doesn't mean anybody who stand in on the stage means they have oil.
不表示说站在台上的这些人每一个都有油。
It doesn't mean you are serving in church, you have oil.
不表示说你在教会有服事，你就有油。
This Bible verse tells us serving in church and having oil is two different things.
这圣经节告诉我们说，在教会里面服事跟你的油是毫无关系的。
How to buy the oil?
怎么样去买油呢？
Is to spend time talking to Jesus.
就是要花时间与基督谈话。
You have that relationship.
你要有这个关系。
Then you have the oil.
你就会有油。
So let us be watchful bride.
因此，让我们要成为这个警醒的新娘。
Watchful about what?
警醒一些什么事情呢？
That your oil is still there.
要警醒说那个油还在那里。
When you have oil, you can meet your bridegroom.
如果你有油的话，你就可以去见你的新郎。
So let us be a watchful bride.
让我们都成为这警醒的这个新娘。
So everybody say, 警醒的新娘。
大家说警醒的新娘。
Watchful bride.
Watchful bride.
Amen. That's the third parable, right?
那是第三个比喻。
I have 5 minutes left.
还有五分钟。
According to the clock, right? I have 5 minutes left. I will tell you the last one, that Jesus is coming back as a king.
最后五分钟告诉你说，耶稣要以王的姿态。
The Bible says, when the king comes back,
圣经告诉我们，当王回来的时候
，we will all be like sheep or goats.
当时候我们都要成为这个绵羊或者是山羊。
We will all make, we will all be like that.
我们都会
You have two choice.
你有两个选择。
One is sheep, ba.
一个选择是你做绵羊，你的叫法是 ba.
Or you become a goat, ma.
或者是你做山羊是 ma.
That's the difference.
这就是它的差别了。
The difference is, okay, I go to Chinese one, okay. The king, when the 人子啊 when Christ come again, he will sit on the throne.There will be people on the right side and left side. The people on the right side are called sheep. The people on the left side are called goat.
Okay, 在那个时候，人子来的时候，他会坐在宝座之上。宝座上有左右边，在宝座的右边这是绵羊，宝座的左边是山羊。
So to the sheep, sorry.
啊，对着绵羊。
He says, "I was hungry, you let me eat. I was thirsty, you feed me. When I was naked, you clothed me. When I have no place to stay, you take me in. When I was sick, you take care of me. When I was in jail, you care for me."
啊，对于这帮山羊说，我饿了，你给我吃；我渴了，你给我喝；我在异乡，你收留我；我衣不蔽身，你给我穿；我患了病，你照顾我；我在监狱，你来探望我。
Then they say, "Since when?"
然后你说，哎，几时嘞？做过这件事啊？
And the Bible in verse 40 says, "When you did it on the least." Among your brothers, you are doing it on me, the king.
然后第四节告诉我们说，当你把这事情做在最小的弟兄身上，你就是做在我身上。
Then he turned around and looked at the goats.
然后耶稣就转向这批的这个山羊。
When I'm hungry, you never feed me. When I was thirsty, you didn't give me anything to drink. When I was overseas, you didn't take me in. When I have naked, you never clothe me. When I was sick and in jail, you never take care of me.
他就告诉他们说，我饿了你没给我吃，我渴了你没给我喝啊！我啊，赤身肉体你没有给我穿，我病了你没有来照顾我，我下了监狱你也没来探望我。
Again they ask, since when?
然后他们又问，哎，几时这件事情
？And verse 45 says, when you didn't do on the least, you didn't do it on me.
耶稣说，如果你这样的事情你没有做在最小的弟兄身上，你就是没有做在我身上。
So when we are the sheep look out for the needs of those who are rejected, where people do not love them, and they take effort, they take time, they take resources, they spend money to take care of these people.
所以这班羊，这班绵羊，他们就是那些刻意去寻找那些被人遗弃的，那些贫穷的，没有人照顾的，他们刻意的去找机会去服侍。
And when they do on these people, the king feels that you are also doing on me. I feel it.
当他们把这些事情做在这最小的人身上的时候，这王就觉得说，这些人是坐在王的身上。
And the king rewards them, and he says, "Inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of this world."
啊，就王就奖赏他们这些绵羊说，这奖赏是继承创世以来永恒的国度。
You see, the reward is always the same. The reward is always inherit the kingdom, reign with Christ.
你知道吗？这个奖赏永远都是一样的，就是要继承这个国度，要与主同作王。
So, when Christ comes, He wants us to reign with Him. That's His desire.
你知道，基督的心意就是当他来的时候，我们要与他一起同
作王。So let us be reminded: when we serve the least, we serve the King.When we don't serve the least, we are not serving the king.
因此，让我们再一次被提醒：当我们去服侍那最小的，我们就服侍我们的君王；当我们不去服侍那最小的，我们就不再服侍我们的君王了。
In your office,
在你的办公室
，I'm sure there will be people. There will be one or two where people reject them. People don't like them.
很肯定的，在你办公室里面有一两个人是被其他人所弃绝的。
People dislike them.
他们不喜欢这些人。
Go and love them.
去爱他们。
They are the least.
他们那是那最小的。
They are not loved.
他们没被爱。
But if you love them, you love Christ.
但是如果你要爱他们，你就爱基督了。
In every place that you go to,
不管你去到哪里
，Let us show compassion.
让我们要彰显出这怜悯的心。
Because when the king comes back, he wants to find his people compassionate.
因为当这个王他回来的时候，他要看到他的子民是蛮有怜悯的。
It's like what our church always have been talking about, selfless.
这就是我们教会常常所提的，就是要无己。
Don't love yourself.
不要爱你自己。
In the end times, people will love themselves.
因为在末后的日子，人很爱自己。
People will love to enjoy.
人很爱享乐。
Invest money to make them their lives more and more enjoyable.
他们投资金钱要使自己的生活更加的享乐。
But the king tells you this.
但是君王告诉你这个。
Don't love yourself so much.
要爱你自己这么多。
Love the rejected.
要去爱那被弃绝的。
Be selfless.
你 要无己。
No need to love yourself because I already love you.
你不需要爱自己，因为我非常的爱你了。
Now go and love other people.
现在你去爱别人。
So live wisely.
因此要智慧的活着。
When our Christ comes back again as a master.
当我们的主以主人的身份回来的时候。
He wants us to be faithful.
他要我们忠心。
He wants us to be fruitful.
他要我们有果效。
When he comes back as our bridegroom.
当他以这个新郎的身份回来的时候
He wants us to be watchful.
他要我们警醒
Watchful that you always have oil.
要警醒确保你时刻都有油
Serving in church doesn't guarantee you oil.
你在教会里面服事不能够确保你就有油的
We've seen it in the Bible verse. We just now we read in the Bible verse.
刚才我们在圣经有读过的
So be careful that you do not lose your oil.
因此你要非常小心不要失去了你的油
And finally, Jesus comes back as the king.
最后，耶稣以君王的身份回来。
What is the king looking for?
君王在寻找的是什么呢？
He's looking for selflessness.
他在寻找无己。
A life that does not love yourself but love other people.
一个不爱自己反倒爱别人的生命。
And that is how we live wisely.In the end times.
这就是你在末后的日子如何智慧的过生活了。
There must be a reason why Jesus start off by all the end times and then tell you four stories.
耶稣从讲末世到最后讲四个预言，他是有理由的。
It's to teach us how to live.
他是要教导我们如何过这生活。
How to wait for him to come again.
如何等待他的再来。
So let us go back and keep on reading these two chapters.
因此让我们回去能够持续的重复的来读这些的经文。
And let's rise to our feet as we sing a song and praise our God and worship Him.
让我们站立起来，唱诗歌来敬拜我们的神。
Amen. Let's all close our eyes.
让我们都闭上眼睛。
And you can start talking to God.
开始的跟神说话了。
If there's any part of the Word of God that has spoken to you,
如果刚才我所讲的一些话的哪一个部分。
You can respond to God.
你都可以用它来向神做反应。
You can tell God, say, Lord, help me to be fruitful.
告诉神的主啊，你来帮助我，让我有果效。
Because I'm afraid all the time.
因为我常常都感觉到害怕。
Help me to be faithful.
帮助我成为忠心的仆人。
So that I'm consistent in every part of my life.
好叫我在生命的每一个方方面面都是有一致性。
Help me to have oil, Lord.
帮助我有油
have that relationship with you
让我与你有个人化的关系
and help me
帮助我
to love the needy of God
帮助那些有需要的人
Yes, Father Lord, we are ready to, for your second coming, O God
是啊，天父，我们准备要来面临你的第二次
再临 Lord, you are not looking for a perfect person
主啊，你不是在寻找一个完美的人
because nobody will be perfect But you are looking for someone whose heart is turned to you, O God.
但是你是寻找一个心向着你的人
Whose life is surrendered to you.
一个生命俯伏在你面前的人
Who is humble and selfless.
是一个谦卑一个无己的人
Help us to keep that oil in our lives.
帮助我们能够保住我们生命的油
Help us to have a relationship with you, God.
帮助我们与你建立个人关系
Help us to reach out to the needy, Jesus
帮助我们能够去接触那些有需要的人
We want to be faithful
我们要忠心
We want to be fruitful
我们要有果效
To glorify your name To glorify your name
来荣耀你的名
Thank you, Jesus
谢谢耶稣
I pray that this morning your word will be like a good seed
我祷告今天你的话就像这好的种子
Planted on good ground
种在好的土壤上
It will grow and bear fruit one day
有一天它要结出果子来
We believe in you, Jesus
耶稣我们相信你
In Jesus' name we all pray
奉耶稣的名我们一起祷告
All God's people say
大家一起说 Amen
Let's give God all the glory
将所有的荣耀归给我们神
Amen.